When you are close enough to the water, a cast button prompt will appear. The cast power will start increasing once you begin casting. This line represents the furthest you can cast. You should aim to release the cast before this line, depending on how far you want to cast. When you apply too much power to your cast, the power meter will go red. This will affect your casting distance and accuracy. This button will start reeling in your line. While fishing, you can increase or decrease the rate your line is reeled in by adjusting your reel speed. You can switch between all your rods, so long as you're within close proximity of your rod stand. You will want to use different casting styles based on the desired casting distance. You can switch between the casting methods before committing to a cast. All casts are executed using the same control methods, whether you are using simple or total cast controls. When you get a bite on a lure or float rig, you need to set the hook to ensure the fish cannot escape. Do this by performing a strike. The timing of the strike determines how well the hook is set in the fish's mouth. Setting the hook poorly will make it easier for the fish to escape. The quality of your strike is determined by the swiftness and direction of the strike action and timing after the fish bites. The better the strike quality, the less chance you have of losing the fish. With the hook set, it's time to reel in the fish.